into all of you. So yesterday or in your previous lesson, we have started our new lesson. The name of the lesson is called Methods of Preserving Food. In that we have discussed the some points. So today we will discuss about one activity. So let's see what is the activity. You have to take one chapati, and that chapati you have to cut into the three pieces. First piece of the chapati you have to keep in a airtight container, okay, or in the box or in a one tin which your lid is very tight. Next chapati or the next piece of the chapati you have to roast it, or you have to make it very crispy, okay, and then you have to keep it as it is. And the third one piece of the chapati you have to keep in the refrigerator. You have to keep in the another box or in the another tin, and that you have to keep in the refrigerator. Okay. So like that, three pieces of the chapati we have keep in a different places. And after some days or every day you have to check it. Okay. Within 2 to 3 days you can see that the chapati that you have kept in the box which is airtight or which is having very proper lid. On the piece of that chapati you can see the cotton like growth, or the green or the bluish or the white color cotton like growth you can see on that. Why this happens on that piece of the chapati, that we will give the name as a A, B and C. So why the growth or the cotton like growth is happens on the piece of the chapati that was kept in the airtight container into the box properly? Because in that box that chapati is having the proper favorable condition for the growth of an organisms, okay, or the growth of an microorganisms. So in the box where we have kept the first portion or the first piece of the chapati, in that tin or in that box the microorganisms get proper amount of food as a chapati, they get proper amount of warmth, they get proper amount of water, and also they get proper amount of the air. So that's why we can say the cotton like structure get appears on the piece of the chapati, and that cotton like structure is nothing but what? One type of the fungus. So in the first container of the chapati, the fungus get favorable condition for their growth. And what is the favorable growth for the fungus? That we can say that food, water, air and warmth. So all these things, all these factors which are necessary for the growth of the fungus, that fungus got, and that's why that fungus started to grow on the piece of the chapati. But we will talk about the remaining two pieces of the chapati. The second one part of the chapati, that is B, that we have roasted and we can make very crunchy. That what happened? Because of the overheat, that microorganisms or which are present on that, it get killed, okay, or they are not getting the proper amount of the food and the water. Means we are roasting for a more time, then what happens? The water gets removed from that piece of the chapati. So the microorganism doesn't get the proper amount of the water, we can say that. And in the B1 or C1, what happened? We have kept in the refrigerator. So in that microorganism doesn't get the proper amount of the warmth, and also we can say the air. So these B and C, in the B and C conditions, the microorganism doesn't get the proper amount of food, water, air and warmth. And that's why that microorganism doesn't grow on that piece of the chapati. But in a condition A, that what happened on that piece of the chapati? Fungus appears, or the growth of the fungus we found out. Why? Because that microorganism, those who are present on the piece A of the chapati, they get the proper amount of water, food, water, air and warmth. In the image you can see that there is a different, there is a fungus, and how it looks like almost like a cotton like structure, okay, that is nothing but the one type of the fungus. So in this way, these are the certain microorganisms, those who are present around us, okay. So let's talk about the food and microorganism. So as we know, microorganisms are present everywhere. They are present in water, they are present in land, in air also. Means everywhere the microorganisms are present, and we cannot see the microorganisms, because as we know, micro means what? Very small. And that is the reason they are called as a microorganisms, means what? They are very tiny. We cannot observe them with our naked eyes. To observe them, we have to use the microscope. That's why they are called as what? Microorganisms. So these microorganisms are present everywhere. Wherever we are keeping the food, all that area also these microorganisms are present. And wherever we are keeping the food, there is air also, water also, and sometimes the water is also present. As we know, for the cooking the food, we are using the water also. Okay. So for keeping the food or while keeping the food, all these things are already present around that food. So it is the possibility that wherever the microorganisms is getting this favorable condition, that time the growth of the microorganism is started to happen in the food material. And when the growth of the microorganism is started to happen in the food stuff, that time what we can say that the food get contaminated or the food get spoiled. Okay. And when the food gets spoiled, some properties of the food is also get changed, as we have discussed in our previous lecture, that bad smell also comes, sometimes the color change, sometimes the taste get changed. Okay. So in this way, all these are the changes happens in the food. Why? Because of the microorganism. And when the growth of the microorganisms are happens into the food stuff or into the food material, when the microorganisms are getting a favorable condition, and which is that favorable condition? Food, water, air, and warm. Okay. So among these, if one factor is also less, then also the food will, then also the microorganisms will not grow properly. Okay. And see, what about the fungus? How the fungus grows? That we have seen in our previous lesson, that is what reproduction in plant. In the asexual reproduction of the plant, we have discussed the reproduction about the fungus also, how it grows, how it get reproduce. Okay. So this is all about the growth of the microorganism in the food. So when we are eating this contaminated or the spoiled food, then our there are the certain effects that happens in our body. Sometimes we are getting vomiting, diarrhea. Okay. Sometimes we are not feeling food. Okay. And continuously we have to go for the washrooms, why? Because we are feeling from the diarrhea, or there is a stomach headache also. Okay. So all these are the symptoms that we can get to know that if we will eat the spoiled food. Okay. So in this way we have to protect the food from these microorganisms growth. And how we can protect the food from these microorganisms growth? Which food preservations method we have to use to protect the food from the microorganisms? That we will discuss in our next period. So today I will tell you goodbye. Here I will end my lesson. Thank you.